like how they have the sides open, you can actually see the equipment inside. Steam one.
So again, we got clear, so we're going to be moving. So again, when we get to the switch over the bridge, we're going to raise Brian's going to hit his horn. That means you actually can move around the coach. You can actually come up to the doorway, take a few pictures, and then go back to your seat so all the passengers can do the same. You also go up to the back of the coach, but I asked for you not to touch a few things. In the middle of black wheels, those are my downbound brakes, please don't touch them. In the right, where the handle engages, that is called my sprocket. It's my outbound brake. It's like a sprocket. It's set. It's on. We can only move that way, but we can't roll back. So don't touch it. And in the left, there is an emergency door. There's no steps to it. So that first step will be a doozy. So do not open or go through it. We'll do all our unloading and loading using this door right here. Views and how Washington could offer. So that day forth, especially on our side, that he was going to come up with a way to get people from the bottom of Mount Washington to the top safely. And eventually came up with this idea of the Cog Railway.
windy up here.
Here we are, top of Mount Washington Observatory, 6,288 feet above sea level. It's windy. Wind about 23 miles an hour.
Just so I can show them. Alright?
Okay,
yeah, they both are. I just want to show them that we have two fits. But if you can see.
It's like flying a staircase, it's a slippery staircase, and if you fall, it's not be good.
Yeah, exactly. Congratulations.
Yeah,
Yeah, but these guys.
if there's CDs, you can switch them.
Keep an eye on everything. I don't need anybody's trouble into me while I'm trying to do this. And also, these metal arms, they don't tickle. So please just stay sheepskin. Again, stand up, take pictures. I'll do it right now, and I'll keep talking about this beautiful mountain and the cool cog railway. Over to your right, that trail is about the mountain all the trails. That is your all-cat ski area. It's from 1905. We have the original part, so it's actually on here, but this steam engine is originally from 1905. After they take three laps, they run at 7:30, now they run at 10, and then they'll take their number back down, and then take another trip up the top.
What?
up here. So this area, millions of years ago, was actually fabulous and grand. With this continent shifting, with the plates shifting, and also the glaciers forming by mountains, there was salt water on these rocks. Eventually, the salt water turned into a lake. That is the white shiny stuff on these rocks. When the early settlers came out here, they saw the white, they call this the White Mountains. A lot of people think because we have snow 9 months out of the year, that's why they call us the White Mountains. That's not true. It's because the mica from the rocks, and the sun hits them, they shine white. That's why we're calling it the White Mountains.
Thank you.
Grover Franklin. Third,